The horror remains unspeakable. 25 years ago, Saddam Hussein unleashed one of the worst poison gas attacks in history. In the town of Halabja, thousands were killed. Now, in Syria, U.S. concerns are growing by the hour that Bashar al-Assad may be planning the same thing against his citizens.
The intelligence that we have raises serious concerns that this is being considered.
U.S. intelligence shows Syria has mixed chemical compounds needed to make sarin gas, a deadly agent that can quickly kill thousands.
The United States and our allies are facing the prospect of an imminent use of weapons of mass destruction in Syria, and this may be the last warning we get.
The U.S. is not precisely saying what the Syrians are doing, but there are two ways of mixing elements to make a sarin-filled weapon.
And you have to handle it very, very carefully because a drop will kill you. So often this will be done at the last minute.
There's another way to do it. Two chemicals are placed in an artillery shell separated by a disc. When the shell is fired, the disc explodes. The chemicals mix, becoming deadly sarin. But at some point, the chemicals are on the move.
Then they have to decide to move it to the place where the delivery system sits. So it may be artillery pieces and an artillery battery of some kind. It could be an airport or a military airbase where the bombers are sitting.
That may be the final opportunity to strike before chemical weapons are used.
Time for talking about what to do may now be coming to a close, and we may instead be left with an awful and very difficult decision.
With the U.S. now believing the Syrian government has chemical-filled bombs, CNN has learned the Pentagon is secretly updating military strike options for President Obama in the event he orders action. A senior U.S. official tells CNN a strike could be carried out with the ships and aircraft already stationed in the region. The planning is being driven by the latest intelligence, which U.S. officials say shows sarin gas has been loaded into aerial bombs at least two locations near airfields. Syria seems to have crossed the line drawn by the president last August.
A red line for us is we start seeing a whole bunch of chemical weapons moving around or being utilized.
This week, that line seems to have shifted with warnings from the president, Secretary of Defense Panetta, and others focusing on what happens if Assad uses the weapons.
You see, these lines become sort of pink lines, right? They're not drawn with a fine pencil, and they move around a little.
Military options for striking Syria spell out the case for why an attack might be called for. U.S. officials say there are multiple reports, more than just satellite imagery, confirming the aerial bombs. The regime is getting more desperate in recent days as fighting has raged around Damascus, leading to worries al-Assad could order a deadly strike that could kill thousands. And unlike Iraq before the U.S. war, Syria's chemical weapons program is openly acknowledged by that government.
These weapons are meant to be used only and strictly in the event of external aggression against the Syrian Arab Republic.
But the president will also be warned of the risks. Civilians could be killed by a deadly release of gas if the sarin isn't all destroyed. Syrian air defenses could bring down U.S. pilots if fighter jets are used. The regime could move its chemical weapons even minutes before an attack. If those weapons start moving around, they become less secure, and that raises an additional dire consideration for the administration. They're watching around the clock to see if any terrorist groups are moving into these areas, trying to take advantage of all of this and seize control of that deadly arsenal.
Chapter 6. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard, as it were the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer.